The new Steam chat is out, and I'll talk about it in this video. Hey guys, salut mes amis och hallo gubbar. Maxime here. To join the beta, you can click on the link in the video description. The new chat has so much new sh** that I'm not gonna be able to bring it all out in this video, but damn, it's a lot.
Oh, and some people have already said that it improves their FPS in-game, but there was no difference for me.
I noticed right away, by the way, that if you're using a skin for Steam, it will probably mess up the interface, so make sure you change your skin back to the default one. Starting off, here's how the new friends panel looks like. In-game friends are now sorted to the top of the friends list and categorized by the game they are playing, with the score showing live. It then goes down to other games, and finally, your tags. If you right-click on someone, you can send messages, view profile, you have different trading options, management options, so for example, change the name, check the name history, and of course, game options. Here's the new chat window. Image previews, embedding, all that jazz has been added, and it looks really clean. You can scroll back to load up to 2 weeks of chat history. Here's your emoticons, and you can upload an image or send your trade URL quick and easy. Another cool feature is the drag and drop quick access bar, also known as the favorites bar. You can drag some of your friends up here, so it's literally easier to reach them. Now, I believe the biggest improvement is for the group chats. The new features to this beta are enough to compete with other services like TeamSpeak, Discord, and you'll see why soon. So it's easy to create a group chat. All you do is invite someone, give it a name, and you're good to go. Now, this left section reminds me of Discord, and it works pretty much the same way. You can add multiple text channels and also voice channels. Speaking of voice, it's been updated to the new WebRTC-based backend and uses high-quality Opus encoding. In other words, the quality is great. And since everything is through Steam, the traffic payloads are encrypted and is relayed through Steam servers, so you get a really good connection. Oh, and your IP address is safe. This is honestly insane. And you can also use it over the web. But I'm gonna stay with the client. The groups stay persistent to your account, so even if you restart Steam, you will be part of the groups, meaning you won't need to create new ones each time. Getting a notification now looks like this, and here's the new sound. Another big part of the update that I spoke about in another video is the invisible feature, which allows you to go offline, but you can still see messages that are sent to you. Anyway, that covers most of the features, but definitely not all of them. Let me know what you think down below. It's really cool to see Steam expanding, especially with the group chat features. Feels like a big step from Valve, and I'm really impressed by what they've managed to do. It's in beta, but expected to be out of beta soon and released to everyone. So that was the video. You can follow me on Twitter or Instagram to keep up to date with what I do. I'll see you guys soon, and go bananas.